Hello, it's Tim Spector here from the ZOE COVID Symptom Study app, giving you another weekly update where a lot has been happening. And generally good news, rates continue to fall nationally across the UK and England on a broad basis. And we're now around 19,000 new cases a day, which is about 40% of where we were at our peak. So those trends are good. The R value is below one, which is where we want it. And we're moving slowly towards the Christmas holidays. Now, there are increasing signs that the numbers of new cases are getting more similar across the regions. So the problems in the north are getting less, and they're sort of catching up a bit of the south, with London in the middle. The figures in London are not that reassuring. They're pretty stable at the moment, not falling as they were a week ago. So we can't be too complacent on that. Wales is the other problematic area, which has more new cases than anywhere else in the UK at the moment, particularly in the south of Wales. And it looks like there was they've had a number of quite severe short-term lockdowns. And one way of looking at the data is that those lockdowns have largely caused a big rebound as people have gone back to socialising afterwards, as a lot of the cases seem to be in the under 40s. So maybe that's a lesson that these short, sharp lockdowns experiments don't really work, and we need a more long-term plan going forward. That's what the data is telling me in any case. For those that study our app in detail, after you've logged your information, you can look at the reports we give the government every day, and included that is now a tier table where your county or a big town, we're starting to record the data that the government used to assign the tiers, which should be reorganized on the 17th of this month. And as the cases are coming down, clearly the position is changing quite fast, and all but about two of these sub-regions are decreasing. And there are three obvious areas where they were put into tier three, but now look clearly like those should be relaxed. And the most obvious ones that I can see are the Bristol area, the Nottingham and Derby areas as well, seem to have been hard done by under the latest guidance. So keep an eye on those. Obviously we've got vaccines coming in, and my colleagues were being vaccinated yesterday at Guy's and St Thomas's Hospital, which is very exciting. This just does mean that for the next few months, it's really just healthcare workers and the elderly, particularly in care homes, that are going to get the vaccine. That's not going to change much in the community, but it will ease pressure on the hospitals, certainly, and make that better. And finally, just want to talk to you about, we're starting to start recording vaccines in the app this week. So we really want everyone who's particularly healthcare workers at the moment, to get on the app and log those symptoms, because there really isn't any good data out there on the small minor symptoms that people might get with these vaccines. And we can do this for hundreds of thousands and millions of people going forward. So really important, we'll tell you which vaccine is behaving the best in different groups if we all work together on this. Finally, just want a brief note about symptoms. Obviously, this app was called the Symptom Tracker originally because that's what it did at a time when the government was just recording two symptoms of disease. That was, if you remember it, fever and respiratory problems. And we found that loss of smell was a much better indicator of anything 10 times better than fever or cough, thanks to your input. And we might need your help again, because we're now asking over 20 symptoms on our app, and the NHS is still only asking those three. And we know that 20% of people are not having those classic symptoms and are testing positive. So we think that if people understood those symptoms more, we'd be able to get this virus under control much better. And that's much more efficient than just doing mass testing to pick up a tiny percentage of people when 20% of people are atypical and need to be allowed access to tests. So that's all we've got time for. Keep logging and stay ahead with our app, and we'll give you more news very shortly.